Okay, let's get started. Are there any additions or modifications to the agenda? Then we'll go on to the presentations or comments from the public if there are some. Anybody want to make some comments? Okay. We'll go right to Deputy Tom.
Thank you, Mayor. For the month of March, and a total of 27 calls for service. And if you guys probably heard me talking earlier that the community event last month was a safety briefing and talk up at the mobile village on Crest Street, which went over quite well. Pretty much it right now.
What are these civil problems?
The civil problems are, we have two civil deputies that work, that serve papers. When they serve papers, they pull a case number or CAD, and so that's what those are, yeah. Sometimes you'll see, five civil problems. That's pretty much five civil papers that were served throughout the city. It's just how they do it, so.
Now, do you happen to know how many calls we did in February?
For February, ended up sending Carol that report.
I didn't print it today.
Didn't print it though, but we do have that.
I can send it out.
Yeah, because the statistician for the county had, he was on baby leave, so he's the only one that could get into his computer, apparently, so I learned that a little bit late, actually, too, so.
Okay. Thank you, Tom.
You bet.
Carol, do you
have any? Just the utility billing report's pretty normal. Had a real low amount of shutoffs this last month, which was wonderful. The well reports coming out about the same every month now. I did want to ask about the budget calendar as far as we need to set up for the budget hearing. So I was thinking somewhere along that, the week of May 2nd through the 5th. We need to set up a day so that I can with the budget committee now, or that's my plan for budget.
What were the dates you mentioned?
The 2nd through the 5th, which is a Monday through the...
Of May?
Through Thursday. Uh-huh, yep.
And that would be a meeting for the budget committee?
Yes, it's the budget committee meeting. And we have to do that, and then I think we have to allow for two meetings in case it doesn't all happen at the first meeting, and then, we have to post notices. I think it's two notices have to be published before we can have a hearing in June, so.
Okay. Anything else?
I had on here about the ethics reminder, but we've all done that now, so thank you.
Alan, do you have anything for us?
I've been working with Westech on kind of a water rate survey and study on our current water rates and looking towards conservation. So they would like to have a work session with the council, and I can send out emails and kind of take a poll of when they'd be good. But they kind of want to get a feeling of which way the directions the city council wants to go for the future. We have some debt service that's going to be coming off in 2018, but we still have the problem about we have a certain small percentage of users in Sublimity that use an extreme amount of water, and they're looking at ways and maybe the graduated system for the cost per 1,000 gallons would hit those higher users a little bit more to maybe force them or to conserve. So they'd like to have a conversation with the council and make sure we're all on the same board. So I'll set that up later on this month. Other than that, City Hall is going to be re-roofed. It's on the schedule. And we replaced the siding over at the city shop. Just doing a few things here before the end of the fiscal year that we had budgeted money for. So that's about it.
Just so are you taking an assessment of our city streets for the budget committee?
Yeah, we have that. We just got a notification. I don't know if you guys had a copy of it in front of you too, but it's another chance for a grant, similar to the one that we got up near the school, and the one that we've gotten a few years ago out here on Parker Street. But you might not have gotten it. It's just a copy of the ODOT. So we'll be applying for that one again.
Alan, what's the time frame to put the roof on?
I'm trying to schedule it for a weekend. I haven't gotten back, or he hasn't gotten back to me. It's Mike Jantz's name, all weather roof. We have a bid in and stuff, and it was a little bit, so we wanted to get it done here in May or June, weather permitting, and we wanted to do it mostly over a weekend if possible to kind of keep the noise and whatnot down for City Hall.
Okay, I was just, if there was, because I know we've got some things coming up where the roofing will probably be a distraction.
It won't be like in the near future with the interviews. Shouldn't affect that at all.
The interviews are,
Okay. Steve, do you have anything on the legal side?
We've got some ordinances and resolutions to talk about, but we'll take those next, I guess.
Okay.
Did you want to say anything about the class action thing?
Because
I didn't know what.
So from time to time, we get various notices that the city may or may not be a beneficiary of a class action lawsuit. So I think this was the most recent one. I guess I forwarded that to you, right, Carol?
You did.
Yeah.
But I didn't know what municipal derivatives.
Yeah. So typical class action lawsuit is the aggrieved parties get a few pennies and the lawyers get a couple hundred million. So that's a typical class action lawsuit. When these things come up, we should have somebody look at it to see if whatever that particular action is about. In this case, whether we were involved in any way with the various financial instruments that they're suing about. To my knowledge, we're not, but I'm not privy to all the different things that we might have going on the financial side of things. My sense of it when I just took a quick look at it is that I didn't think any of that would apply to us.
It was like in the 1990s, I think it went back.
Yeah, and usually the benefit for us, because we're such a small city, and if we were ever involved in anything, it would be on such a small number that the actual amount we would be receiving is likewise very small. So if somebody wants to spend some time to research it, somebody wants to do that, it can make sense. It doesn't make sense to pay somebody to research it when likely there's no real benefit to us. So that's why I wasn't going to spend a bunch of time trying to dig through it all. So if anybody's so inclined, I guess Carol has it and they can stop by and pick up the packet and go through it and see if there's anything there. My hunch is it's probably not worth our time.
Okay, we'll go on to the resolutions and ordinances. The first one is Ordinance 727 of the Northwest Natural Franchise Agreement. Do we have a number for this, Carol?
727, yes.
So we have a...
See, he has one ready.
I'll have one you can sign here, right? I'm assuming it gets passed.
Oh, do we have to read this?
Right, so our franchise with them was for 20 years, and it has now run out. So this is basically renewing it. It's more or less along the lines that we've had already. It calls for a 3% franchise fee to the city. And so there's a couple little just technical changes that got made, but nothing of any substance. So if the city's so inclined to approve another 20-year non-exclusive franchise to Northwest Natural Gas, and you wanted to approve that tonight, you would have to have two meetings tonight of the title. And
do you know what the rate was 20 years ago? What's been the rate?
3%. Yeah, it hasn't changed, so.
And you don't know gas is pretty much the same as it was 20 years ago? I haven't this question asked.
I don't know what kind of income we get out of this. I don't know. Do you have any guess?
I have a guess. I think it's about $17,000 or so a year. I think that's the one that comes in. And it's on population, I think, isn't it? Isn't that how it's figured?
Well, we get paid based on the gross revenue that they are earning in the city limits.
Okay.
Are there any more questions? So, we have to make a motion.
Well, you could read it twice by title, and then somebody can make a motion.
Okay, I'll read it twice. An ordinance granting a non-exclusive gas utility franchise to Northwest Natural Gas Company, fixing terms, conditions, and compensation of such franchise, repealing ordinance number 383, and declaring an emergency. Okay, I'll read it again. An ordinance granting a non-exclusive gas utility franchise to Northwest Natural Gas Company, fixing terms, conditions, and compensation of such franchise, repealing ordinance number 383 and declaring emergency. We'll entertain a motion to pass that.
I'll make a motion that we accept ordinance 727 with Northwest Natural Franchise, or Northwest Natural Gas, as stated in the ordinance.
No, sorry.
It's been moved and seconded that we pass this ordinance 727. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. We have a resolution. Number 1516-4 to make line item transfers within the streets funds. Is everybody aware of this, what's happening here?
Yeah, and I had a couple questions. Do we know what it's going to cost us for insurance and for training, what we need to have? What's going to be the impact on the city if we buy this? Because I know we're going to have insurance, and I imagine...
We went over that in the last meeting. Go ahead.
Yeah, but they were going to have numbers for us, I thought.
Yeah, last meeting I did. It was $550, I think, quoted for insurance by Madison and Davis for the vehicle itself, and it was $1,000 a year recertification for the lift and everything. So figured in the cost of fuel and maintenance on that. I talked to Carol, and I actually have some numbers written down for a budget for next year.
So $1,000 per year for me for certification to get? Then what about training for you guys?
The training is done with SCTC at no cost, and then we do refresher courses every year annually with them. They also put us together with the name of the company that does a recertification, and this year they just did the certification in March, so it'll be good for a year. We won't have to worry about that. The training's done. There's no special certification training. It's just signed off by a competent operator, and we'll get that from SCTC.
So, are there any other questions? So do we have to read this twice too?
No.
So we'll entertain a motion to pass this resolution. Anybody wants to make a motion?
I'll make a motion that we approve resolution 1516-4 to make the line item transfer from the street fund for the purchase of the boom truck from SCTC.
Is there a second to that?
Second.
Been moved and seconded that we pass resolution number 1516-4 to make line item transfers within the sheriff's fund. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Opposed.
Motion carries. The next one is a resolution number 1516-5, a resolution for the destruction of pockets. City of Sublimity resolves as follows. Whereas that the official clerk records retention and destruction clerk be authorized to destroy the physical records excluding payroll, council, planning commission meetings, minutes, and land use files of fiscal year 2004 to 2005 and all previous years. Is this standard procedure?
Yes. It's well within the, actually it's every 7 years you can destroy these files and allow them for over 10. I just want to get some of it cleaned up that's in there.
Okay.
So.
Are there any other questions that need to be addressed? Not all entertaining.
How much is there, Carol? How many boxes?
It's about eight, maybe eight of the paper type boxes. I was going to set it up for the shredding company that shreds on site so we could come and we would actually see it. Yeah, we would actually see it. It's not something that we're going to be shredding.
That's good. Is there a motion?
No.
Yeah. Well, we'll entertain a motion to pass this resolution or deny it.
I'll make a motion to pass resolution number 1516-5.
You second that?
I'll second.
Been moved and seconded to pass resolution for the destruction of the file. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Okay, the next item is the expenditures, and they're before you, April.
I just had a question, maybe for Jim, or maybe Al, maybe one. Do we have some clothing allowance here for the city for the year?
Clothing allowance?
Yeah.
I'd have to go back and look if it's... I think $100 for pants, $300, $400 for boots, and I'm not sure of the rest of it.
I'll check, Brian. I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah. Because I think this, well, there's a clothing allowance of $350. I'm just wondering what we have for yearly. I don't know how that works. I haven't seen one that big, so I don't know if that's a. Once a year, or we do that every 6 months, every 2 months?
It's just once a year.
Where is that you're seeing that?
Under the Northwest Preferred. And that's boots right there. That's these.
Then we also have shirts and that with identification that they are from the city of Sublimity.
Well, that I get. I mean, I'm just curious on what the allowance is for that per year. We must have something in there.
It is. So it actually was updated when Council Riker was here. So it hasn't been that many years ago. But I don't know the exact thing. We don't use it we're under that amount.
Carol, it's my understanding that this item under Spear Hoyt Planning Attorney, that bill goes to the developer, right?
Some of it will. I'm not sure all of it will. I'll have to see what.
I was under the understanding that they would. Is that right, Steve? I don't know.
Yep. Typically, so when an applicant signs, they should be signing a document that says they're liable for all city's engineering and legal costs, etc. So,
I was going to ask Joy if I wasn't sure. I know there was some of their costs before was when in the ones
December was when they talked about appealing it, and that, so that was part of it. I didn't know if that was still going to be part of it or not.
Yeah, my understanding that that was supposed to be.
This all should be.
Yeah.
This time, for sure.
Yeah. So can you make sure that that goes to the right people?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I think the typical process would be that, you know, we're going to get the bill for whoever we hired for these services, and we have to pay the bill, and then we get reimbursement. So then we need to bill out to the applicant so that we get reimbursed. So I imagine if you send out a bill that says this is our expenses.
Okay.
Are
there any other items that you want to look at under expansion? Expenditures. If not, we'll go on to the city council meeting. We had the last time.
We need a motion to pay.
Oh, we have to have a motion to pay the bill. Huh?
I'm making a motion to pay the expenditures for April 2016.
I'll second it.
Thank you. Second to pay the bills for April. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. This next one, minutes of March 14th meeting, was a rather long, carried out, drawn out situation, but if anybody wants to challenge any of the stuff in there, we'll very straightforward.
I make a motion that we accept the minutes of the March 14th, 2016 council meeting as presented.
There a second?
Yes, sir.
Then move the second that we accept the city council meeting for March 14th. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. The next thing is an agreement for payroll assistance. It's called the contract with the City of Silverton Instructional Help with the DeSalle program.
Can I speak to
that? Yes,
right?
Yes, please do.
I've asked the City of Silverton, Kathleen Zaragoza from the City of Silverton, to help us when Carol has questions regarding payroll and any other issues that we might have with DeSalle. Kathleen has agreed to do that for us free of charge to come down and or have Carol call. I asked them to come up with an agreement for payroll assistance specifically, because they have a payroll person in Silverton that can come down and help us with our program to make sure all of our rates are correct, make sure all of our files are correct. And then that, then we can do our payroll in-house. We won't have to go out to Volk, Carlisle, and Smith. I think that we need this because at the time when Carol retires and we have, before we have a city administrator, we need someone that can help our office staff take care of payroll and that we don't lose anything through the cracks. Our agreement with them would be $30 an hour for Sarah, the payroll person from Silverton, to come down. That would probably happen probably twice a month when we do payroll. If we need her to come down, she will come down. If we just need to answer a question over the phone, then it would just be a phone call. That's why I think we need it. Does anybody have any questions?
Will this clarify or get this past deductions tax?
Yes.
Cleared up at least, so it's not an ongoing problem.
Correct. What Gene is talking about is we. I was made aware that we have a unemployment insurance rate that isn't correct in our system, and they'll be able to come in and tell us what rate is that we're supposed to be using, what unemployment insurance rate we're supposed to be using for the state of Oregon. when we took it back from Old Carlisle and Smith, it was my understanding, as I kind of worked through this situation, that we didn't change that rate and we were using a rate that had just been in the system. So that's one issue that Kathleen will be able to rectify quickly. And then the other issue is with our federal payroll tax that we have to pay. They changed from quarterly payments to semi-weekly payments, and that we didn't take care of that right away, so we incurred an interest and penalty from the IRS.
How much was that?
It was $500.
I think
twice, right?
Yeah, it was around $1,000 between the two. I think that's fixed now.
Yeah.
I think that we fixed that part now. We didn't know from July until.
Things like that, I don't want to fall through the cracks when we make a change. You know, payroll is simple, but you have to have everything correct in the system in order for it to be simple.
Well, I think it's a good move. I think we should endorse this thing. Pass it, whatever needs to be done.
Does anybody have any questions?
Do you have one of those?
Yeah.
So, is there any more discussion that we need to go with? Not to ask for a motion.
I'd like to make a motion to enter into an intergovernmental agreement with Silverton to engage in the services. I'll read this top line. Would that be appropriate?
Sure, go ahead.
This agreement is made to engage the services of the City of Silverton to provide payroll services to the City of Sublimity, and is made under the authority of ORS 190.003 to 190.110.
And we second that.
And move to second that we approve this agreement, payroll assistance. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you.
This next item is there's a vacancy on the Planning Commission. And I was under the impression that Joe Wolf had resigned because he was moving away, and that was the reason he was resigning. And now I understand that his job didn't pan out, and he's building a house over here. So, has he resigned?
Yes.
He has.
He has.
In February, he resigned.
Yeah, it was January 29th.
Okay. So how do we go about filling this? We put it out on a notice saying anybody that interview people, or what? How do we fill this?
And I have a recommendation for that. We did put that out as a notice in the newsletter, and I've been advised we had one person gracious enough to volunteer to fill the rest of Joe's term, because that's what the appointment, or not the appointment, but the vote of the council. So we choose Dolores Morris is here tonight, and I think she's expressed an interest in filling that position. It's the only person that I'm aware of that has stepped up.
How long is that position valid for you?
Well, since February, I know word's been out. Officially, it came out in April. So
how long does Joe's term go again?
Well, it's a 4-year term, so however many years he's been on there, so maybe 3.5.
Yeah.
Carol,
he's probably at least 2. I'm not sure.
No, he hasn't been that long. Well, maybe 2 years. So
maybe other people didn't know about it. Maybe we should put it in the newsletter.
It is. It's in the newsletter.
Okay.
Yep, it's in the newsletter.
Okay.
So I'll make a motion, if there's no other discussions, to vote to have Dolores Morris fill that vacancy and complete the term of Joe's position. So I don't know, I should give you an opportunity, I guess. I don't know if that's appropriate at this point. If you want to say anything, or if the council has any questions before I...
Well,
what's your interest in it, Dolores? I mean, are you just...
Basically, the reason why I'm interested in it is because I want to keep... I think we need to do some changing through the Planning Commission. I know we can't do it now with the Hassler one, but I think that we need to work as a Planning Commission, and I would be willing to do that, work on getting it changed so that when our town mushrooms to 7,000 like Staten's has, that we have some control over having some parks and having some more police coverage and just the things that I brought up at the meetings of my concerns and stuff like that. And that's why I'm interested in serving on it. Be it 2 years, 3 years, or do they then vote? Do they then go up for an election again then?
It'll be appointed by the council.
Okay.
Voted on by the council when the vacancies open.
Okay.
So I make a motion to have Dolores Morris fill that position.
Second. Been moved and seconded that we have Dolores Morris fill with Joe Wolf's remaining tenure on the Planning Commission. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Congratulations.
Okay. The next is revenue statement. Are there any questions about that?
No. So the gas franchise,
17,000.
That
was
great.
Is it on here?
Yeah.
They want
a year, so. Yep. Yeah, franchise is on
there. I was trying to find it how often they paid.
They pay annually. A lot of them pay every month or quarterly, but they just once a year.
You know, I do know that there's been questions on the franchise fees, and if we go above a certain percentage, it goes back. Actually, it's a tax
on to the customer.
Yes, passed back on to the customer. So keeping the franchise fees as low as possible and not incurring more expenses on the citizens. You know what I mean? Mandated tax.
Okay.
Question, Ray?
Yeah.
On the franchise, 20 years, that sounds like an awful long time. Is that normal? I mean, can things happen between, you know, in 20 years' time where the rates could go up or down? Or?
Well, it's already passed. We passed it tonight.
Well, okay.
Come back in 20 years.
it does say in here, Wayne, that the rate can be adjusted every 5 years, the first, second, and third successive five-year periods.
Okay.
So if the city does say, you know, we want a higher rate, we have to give them a 30-day written notice. Either party actually could do that. But that, so every 5 years that could be adjusted if needed.
Okay.
Sure.
Anything else about the revenue? If not, we'll go on. Is there any continuing business we need to address? Okay, I don't have anything on the sewer committee, but we're gonna as soon as the fiscal year is concluded, we're gonna be meeting with the state and people and see where we're at. Bob, do you have anything on public works?
Well, I would put my stuff earlier.
Okay. Jim?
The only thing that happened, it will be presented at the budget committee, I'll get it out to all the counselors, is we got the contract for police services for the next coming year. So, going through, there is a slight increase.
Is it going down?
No, it didn't go down. But there are ways, if we wanted to, we could probably find a less experienced deputy and this comes in and I know I'm in trouble tonight.
Still around for this time.
No, that's, you know, it's based on their years of experience and their rank with the department. So.
Brian, do you have anything?
Just the only thing for the planning commission. I think, and I'm not sure, I don't know if you know, that the first of every, each year, January, the commission, planning commission needs to elect the chair and the co-chair. And I don't know if that was done, somebody that's included on there. They're supposed to do that every year. So I haven't heard that that's been done. Just to remind me that at their next meeting, they'll need to select their chair and co-chair. Or vice chairs.
Good.
I don't know who that is. Who is the co-chair? Do you know? Okay. Yeah.
Do you know, Wayne, who the co-chair is of the planning commission?
No, I don't.
So next meeting, just
maybe I should send them the ordinance or something?
Yeah, or send it to Randy. Or send it to the entire.
I think there was one vacancy or one meeting that Randy wasn't here, and I think I think Joe Wolf took over.
Yeah, well, then they need to fill, the commission will need to vote for a chair and co-chair at the next meeting. That's it.
Thank you. Jim.
All right, again, a couple of things. So our interviews start this Thursday for the utility billing clerk. We have 7 scheduled for Thursday, and then we have a few more that I think there's 2 more that we have to add to that list. And we'll get them down to 3 or 4 that we can bring in front of council for an interview. Reviews are due, so if there's any input for reviews, let me know. The school excise tax, Jane Knopfinger's sending me the information. It's set by the state, and that tax is collected quarterly and is in reserve for new construction or for additional constructions to accommodate the growth of a school because of the new homes that were built in the city. So that's, but she'll get me the information and I'll present it hopefully the next time. And Wayne had brought up last month about a budget report or where the city is at financially.
Well, no, I just asked the question. Since I've been coming to the council meetings, I don't know if the city's in the red or they're in the black or what, because nothing has ever been presented as far as financial.
Correct, and you bring up a very valid point. And I might add that it would be beneficial if we had a report that showed where we're at for each budget category. Not necessarily if our city's in the red or black or what have you. But, and that report can be generated by our system that we have. Mm-hmm. So I hope that we can implement that in the future.
Sure.
That's all I have.
Okay. Is there any other business that should come before this council? If not, we'll call it for adjournment. Anybody want to make a
motion that we adjourn?
I'm sorry.
Can we move to second for adjourn?
Aye.
Aye.
What are you doing?